Welcome back to more Trails of the Sky. Last time we left off, we were going to head over to the orphanage because someone burned it down. And well, yeah, that's going to require some investigating. I don't have to worry about the treasure, I just have to make sure the orphans are still alive. Man, being an orphan wasn't bad enough to have someone burn down your whole house. It's like doubly screwed over right there. Almost there, so a little more walking screen. Here's the bend. I think we have to. No, we don't go directly to the orphanage. I think we go. Oh. Okay, we go directly to the orphanage. I thought we were going into town because that's where the call came from, and it would be there instead of, you know, at the charred remains of their home. Because that's just very depressing. Speaking of very depressing, this music! Oh boy, this is gonna be a sad mission. Dude, this is terrible. It's just gone. Who do we have here? Are you here from the Bracer Guild? Yeah. You're all from Verona, right? Yeah, we came to pick up the pieces. We were here last night around midnight trying to fight the fire. As you can see, it could have gone better. So then, what about the matron? What about Matron Teresa and the kids? They're all fine. Oh, thank Christ, that looks pretty fun. It looked pretty screwed over in the last cutscene we saw of them. Don't worry. Alright, now they're sleeping in Amarona's Inn. Given the size of the fire, it's a miracle that no one was badly hurt. Miracle? Jesus Christ, it's like a freaking Superman swept by and saved them or something. Thank goodness. Yes, at least that's something. We're here now to clean up what we can. How about you two? We really ought to check up on everyone at the inn. Sorry, but that'll have to wait. Huh? Now that we're here at the scene of the crime, there's a lot that strikes me as weird. We need to find what clues we can before the trail goes cold, so to speak. I know how you feel, but this has to take precedence right now. Right, we're braces after all. We'll find out what happened. Right, so let's see what we can find. Look at you. Looks like you'll have your hands full. Good luck. Okay, so let's investigate the area. This was once a wall. There was once a wall. Well, it was once a wall, it's now rubble. This place is ruined. Hey, do you smell something strange? Yeah, I think I know why. Barrels with food in them have been scorched black. The milk tank has fallen on the side and it's empty. The top of the flower bed is all over the ground. I hope we can end this so we can get away from the depressing music. The herbs have been uprooted and strewn about the garden. Firewood for the stove has been scattered around. How do you get all the way from never mind, I think I have it closer to the stove, but I guess we have one fire. The herbs have been approved soon by the garden. Yeah, us walking around it isn't gonna help much either. Man, I was in shock yesterday. I mean, seeing the sky go all red in the east over Verona, I tried to get here as quickly as I could, but everything was already gone. Since the fire's burnt so much, I guess the only thing to do is to rebuild. I don't know what Matron Teresa is going to do. I mean, it's going to be really expensive. The door's been completely wrecked. It's all pitch black, huh? What's wrong? Maybe this is just me, but does this hinge look weird to you? Like it's been torn off or something? It does, actually. As if it happened before the fire started. Alright, we've taken a good look around. What do you think? Yeah, I'm not so sure, to be honest. First off, the fire doesn't appear to have been started in the building. It was most likely started outside. Outside, over here. Looks like this area was the point of origin. Oh, where the wall collapsed. But how can you tell? Because the fire damage is worse here than anywhere else. Compare it to the areas nearby and you'll see. Oh, you're right. So it started here and then spread. You know what that means. Yeah. My thoughts exactly. The smell everywhere is some highly flammable oil. It's everywhere around here, so it has to be the fire's point of origin. No way. Plus, don't you think it's weird how everything outside is scattered around? Even people fighting a fire wouldn't have done that to the herb garden. It's not a coincidence. Someone did this. Is it true? Cole! I didn't know you were here. But why? Why would anyone do this? I mean, so many irreplaceable memories. I have so many irreplaceable memories of this place. Why? How? How could someone be so cruel? Cole. I'm sorry. I'm just so confused. Aw. You're not alone in that feeling. I barely know the place, and this bothers the heck out of me, too. It's hard to believe that anyone can be capable of something this awful. Still. But the mansion and the kids are all okay. So we can just be thankful for that, right? Thank you, that does help. I just started morning classes when the dean came to see me. He said that he heard that the orphanage was in flames. And while I was on the way here, all I could think about was they're fine, they're alive. Adios was watching over them. We heard they're all safe in the end of Marona, safe and sound. We just finished up here, so we're planning to go see them. You want to come with us? Yes, I would like that very much. Alright then, to Marona we go. Did we get away from the depression music? Oh, that's much, much better. Camera. Okay, it's obviously not this room. There's only two rooms here. Matron, everyone! Miss Cole! You came! Oh, look at the kids. Is anyone hurt? You're okay. I is okay. Thank goodness. I'm glad you're here. Is that Stone? Josh, shall I see with you? Yes, is everyone... Since someone contacted the guild, we're investigating the incident, and thought we'd stop by. I see. Thank you for taking the time. Investigating, you mean about the fire, right? Do you know who did it? How to put it? Oh, so who's hungry? I missed breakfast, so I was thinking of getting some food. Good boys and girls who joined me will get some sweet treats. Really? I want some pudding, but... Come on, Clem. Huh? Quit griping and come on. Let's go downstairs, Miss Cole. Okay. That's sweet. That was close. I really wouldn't want the little kids to hear about this. Indeed. Although I have a feeling that Mary understands at least some of what's happened. Yes, she's great. I'm happy to have her around. Now you were saying? Please tell me what you can do. Tell me what you can. Thanks for understanding. Okay, then. Yeah, someone burned your ship down? First, we checked out where the fire started, and it does appear that it was set deliberately. My suspicions were correct then. I've always been careful about fire, so I suspected it might be something like that. Do you have any idea who could have done this? Whoever was responsible must have had some kind of motivation. I have no idea. We have no money to speak of, nor has anyone ever borne a grudge against us. So it wasn't robbery, and it wasn't for revenge. I thought it was possible that someone did it just for fun. You happen to notice anything unusual leading up to or during the incident? Any strange people hanging around the orphanage, for instance? Yes, actually. Not during the daytime when you were there, but afterward. Though I can't imagine he would do something like this. Who's he? While we were trying to escape from the burning building, the beams fell and blocked our way through the entry hall. But then he showed up and helped us all get free. We owe him our lives. Really? What, was he Maronian? Right after he helped us, he called the villagers over and left in the confusion. I asked the other villagers about him, but no one seems to know anything. Sounds suspicious. What business would anyone have around the orphanage at such a late hour? Do you notice anything in particular about him? He was a man, maybe in his late 20s. He had brilliant silver hair. Silver hair? He had a troubled look about him, though, that made him seem far older than he looked. But he didn't strike me as a bad man. He sounds suspicious, but he did help you out. It doesn't sound like our guy to me. Joshua, what's wrong? What's with the goofy stare? That was nothing. Perhaps he was just a bracer who happened to be passing by. I think we should discard him as a suspect. Okay. Pardon me. Oh, hi, Cole. What happens with our children? They're downstairs having some dessert. Mission Teresa, you have a guest. Hmm? Pardon my intrusion. Oh, Mayor Dolmar. So the persons I met yesterday are here as well. Genius reputation for responding quickly is well earned. Well, now then. It's good to see you again, Matron Teresa. After I heard what happened, I came over as quickly as I could. I'm glad you're safe. Thank you, Mayor. It's very kind of you to come by. I know you're a very busy man. Nonsense. It is my responsibility to look after all the areas in the region. More to the point, those who did this must not be allowed to get away with it. Joseph has always loved that place. Such an atrocity. Allow me to express my most heartfelt condolences. Thank you. But I'm sure that we would be relieved that the children are alive as well. My sole regret is that my mementos of him were lost in the fire. Matron Teresa. Tell me, Bridges, have you thought who might have done this? We've only begun to investigate, so it's too early to say, sir. But it does look like it might have been done simply out of malice or whatever. I see, that's a terrible thought. There's nothing so heinous to happen in such a peaceful place. Pardon me, Mayor. What of it? Do you think that these people might have had a hand in this? Hold up, who do you mean by these people? You encountered them yesterday. The ruffians down at the warehouse district in ruin. Oh, them. Pardon my bluntness, but what makes you suspect them? They've been openly defying the mayor for quite some time now. They certainly seem to get their kicks out of causing problems for him. And since he and Major Teresa are friends, it... Gilbert! Sir, law speculation does no one any good. This is a dire offense. We must have no false accusations. My apologies, sir. It was foolish of me. I think it would be best to let the bracers identify and locate the ones responsible. Can I count on your help? Sure, leave it to us. We will devote our full attention to it, sir. Good, I'm glad to hear it. By the way, Major Teresa, I do have one question to ask. What is it? What do you plan to do with the orphanage now? Rebuilding would take some time, and not an inconsiderable amount of Mira. Honestly, I'm at a loss. We have a modest reserve of Mira, but the cost will be phenomenal. Matron, I was afraid of that. I have a proposal of sorts for you. What is it? At Dolmar Estate in Gronsol, I have a villa. It is only used for special occasions, so... What say you have your children stay there for a little while? Oh? And of course, charging rent would be particularly boorish of me. You'd be welcome to stay there for as long as our building process takes. There's no need for you to shoulder the burden of our troubles. But the villa sits unused. If you have any misgivings, then I will grant you control of the grounds. Think of it as a well-deserved reward, if you will. Mayor, may I have some time to think it over? Your offer is most generous, but I can barely process it with what's going on. Perfectly understandable, you should get some rest. I must be off as well. If you decide to accept, please feel free to contact me. I will. Thank you so very much. Let's get going, Gilbert. Yes, sir. Well, that was a shock. He's certainly the generous guy on par with Mayor Maybell. Indeed, particularly in light of his being a former noble. What do you intend to do in regards to the mayor's offer, Matron? Well, what do you think of the situation? Conventional wisdom dictates that you should accept it. However, once you've gone to Gransel, never mind me. Gilbert, you always were such a thoughtful child. It's all right. I want you to give me your honest opinion. The herb garden and the people I care about would be gone, and with you and Joseph gone, I feel like all my good memories will fade away. I'm sorry, just being stupid and selfish. I share your feelings. The orphanage is my home, memories of him as well as of children's memories. But though memories are precious, having a place to live is of the utmost importance. Yes, ma'am. I believe this will all be settled soon. Please try to focus on tending to the campus festival for now. The children are really looking forward to it. Yes, ma'am. So, Joshua, I wish I could be more help, but I must leave the investigation in your hands. You will handle it, ma'am. We're going to take down the culprit. You can count on that. Yeah. This year has turned into a royal mess. Where should we start the search? Maybe we should go to the guild and report to John. And to Jean. We can figure out a plan of attack then. Sounds good to me. What's wrong? You look like something's bugging you. Oh, I'm sorry. My mind's upset. My mind is just all over the place right now. I know how you feel. By the way, Joseph was Matron Teresa's husband, right? Yes. He died several years ago. But he meant a great deal to me as well. I see. Does that mean you're from the orphanage too? No, nothing like that. He just did a huge favor for me a long time ago. We grew close again when I came to Ruin to attend the academy. Oh, I see. In other words, every time you came by to play, you ended up helping out, like part of the family. Yes. He's like a father to me, but the shock I experienced was nothing compared to that of the matron and the other children. But we managed somehow. Miss Cole! Harry, what's gotten into you? What's gotten you in such a hurry? Listen, Clem's gone. Again? Maybe he just left Marona? Can you give us more details? Okay. After the old man showed up, Clem went upstairs. In a couple of minutes, he came back down all red, saying, they're not getting away with this. Then he just ran off. I wonder who you meant. You don't suppose it's... Yes, I believe it was the Ravens. You probably overheard what the steward said. Oh no, I hope he's not going to find them himself. It can't be. I can't allow this. I have to find him at once. We'll come with you. If we hurry, we might be able to catch him before he gets to Ruin. Miss Cole, don't worry. I'll bring him back home safely. You're just look after the other children, alright? Okay, good luck. Let's head back to Ruin. Alright. So I'm going to pause and see you in Ruin. See you then. Okay, we're back in Ruin now. And now we're gonna go find the kid. Darn, it's almost noon already. And he made it across before we can get there. No! Clem, please wait. It's all use. I guess we can't hear you. Crap, why does the spruce have to go up now of all times? It can't be, wait 30 minutes? Oh no, if we don't do something, what do we do? What can we do? Please, Cole, calm down. You haven't forgotten the results about the bridge, are you right? Huh? How did people get across before the bridge was built? Oh, boat! That's right. If I remember correctly, there's a boat right behind the hotel. Alright, let's use that then. Inside and out. Oh, that's a bar. Hotel's over this way. I still have to go inside and out. her in a boat. You run out of the boat, is that correct? Yes, go downstairs, go down these stairs and take a ride. Okay, where it is. Downstairs to the right, thanks. Dear God, woman, did you just yell at the poor man's face? What do you want? Can we rent your boat? We need to get across as quickly as possible. I'm afraid not. The Duke's bell has already reserved it. Come back later. No, no. Please, won't you help us? There's a little boy in grave danger. Don't go shedding tears like that. It reminds me of my granddaughter. I don't like seeing her upset either. Alright, I suppose it can't hurt. Get on board. Thank you, sir. You're a lifesaver, mister. I'll just tell that Duke bell that the boat's being repaired. You know how to handle the boat, boy? Yes, sir, I'll manage. Come on, both of you. You don't get to talk to official pressure business. We need the boat now. Hell, this suffice to, you know, get teary eyed. It seems to be the southernmost part of the warehouse district. The heck was that? Oh, it's the bird. Zeke! Okay, I understand. Looks like he's gone as far as he can go. Let's get him moved then. That's probably where we'll find a hideout. Roger that. Okay. This is one of our houses that isn't locked. Don't play it dumb. I know you guys did it. I'm not gonna let you get away with it. It's no point talking about. No place for little kids. Now go home and get back to sucking on your mama's tit. Nice one, man. Yeah. I'm gonna punch all the other guys. I'm surprised I'm pissed off about. I don't have a mom, you jerks. I have the matron. You don't get to make fun of her. Ow, my ribs. You got a lot of attitude, punk. Maybe you need some discipline. How's about 100 whacks on the ass? Stop this! It's you! Miss Cole, how can you be so cruel to a child like this? It's disgusting, you should be ashamed of yourselves. Oh, hell no. Hey, Missy. Who are you to look down on this just because of your looks, rich snob? How many bridges do you think it'll take to beat us? Stand aside, Cole! We'll buy some time. Get the kids as far away as you can. No, let me fight, please. You can fight?! I don't enjoy it, but I was taught to use a sword to protect others. I think now is the right time. What?! A self-defense rapier. Let the child go, please! Otherwise I will use force if I have to. Oh wow, that's so hot. Dude, get your mind off your boner right now and focus! You expect us to let this Braculo mountain off of us? We're the Ravens, you need to learn not to mess with us. Alright, are we doing some refighting right now? Hell gate! Oh dear, that is the good magic. Oh, this son of a bitch can heal fuckers! These guys don't really hit for much. But now this guy has to die! That was a bit overkill. I can't hit all three of you. Good! Okay, now they're all in the circle. Still no, that's for Joshua's final form, but it'll do. These guys have got some kind of monsters. Even if she's a prisoner, there's something weird about this chick. That was awesome, Miss Cole. Yeah, nice going, Cole. You must have learned the art of sword from someone very skilled. No, I'm still just a novice. Fighting any longer would serve no purpose. Please return the boy. You bitch! We ain't gonna let you get hit and you make fools of us and get away. Enough! Who's there? Reinforcements? Hey, it's been a long since it's been so long you've forgotten my voice. Anarchist! You're here! What are you doing here? You know these guys? Reyes? Yes. Oh, my balls! What are you fools doing? Fighting with girls and beating up a little kid? Is that what's come to? You shut up! You left us! So who are you to give us orders anymore? My balls! Oh, it hurts! You were saying? Hey, I can take it easy! It's about the kid! We'll let him go, see? Miss Cole! Thank goodness you're all safe now. You should have done that from the start, you friggin' bonehead! What a bunch of mean jerks. How do you know when to show up? I just talked to Gene, that's all. He said the newbies were somewhere investigating the arson case, so... Hey, kid. What? You also got something all the way here by your lonesome. But you're really pushing your luck. You should worry about your mom. You shouldn't let your mom worry like that. Clem. Yeah, she ran all the way here. Patriot! What? Why have you come here? I inquired at the guild as what was going on, and I was like, here. Clem, really, you know better. I'm not apologizing this time. I'm gonna get these to start firing. Clem! Make sure Teresa don't scold them. It wasn't my intent. I understand how you feel, Clem. Believe me, I do. The house was important to everyone who lived there with you, to all of us. However, getting yourself killed and not bringing it back. All that I want is for everyone to be safe. Nothing else matters. So please don't put yourself in danger. Oh, that's kinda sweet. I'm such a sucker for this stuff. Clem, I'm really glad he's okay. Jeez, women and kids, always the same. Hey, Bracer Kid, you should get the matron and Brad out of here. You know this place is no place for them. I don't mind, but what would you do, Agate? I've made up my mind. I'm going to remind you, Cetus, who runs things and why! I need to crack a few skulls! No, no! My balls! I see. Guess you'd prefer not being interrupted then. Agate, please! Anything but below the belt! Below the belt is always an option. I thought it wasn't. It always is. Thank you very much. I wish I had felt worse to express my gratitude. You really don't need to thank us. We're just doing our jobs. Still, you sure you don't want to escort back to Morona? It's fine. The gold sideway is like my backyard after all. Apparently, I don't want to get caught in trouble at school. I need to worry. I will accept full responsibility, Matron. Thank you, Cole, but it's fine, really. I want you to focus on preparing for the campus festival. All the children will be looking forward to it. Yes, ma'am. We've made it in time. I brought the boat back. Thanks. Sorry for making you do that on your own. Don't worry about it. It wasn't a tough job. Are you my graduate as well, Joshua? It's cool. All you guys, actually. Thanks for helping me today. That was stupid, really stupid. Clem. I thought maybe I could get back at them. And then you have to come and save me. You must think I'm a complete loser. We don't think that at all. You're not a loser. What? You risk your life limit because something important to you. That's no feat. That's no mean feat, even for grown-ups. Personally, I thought you were pretty awesome. Mr. Joshua, you should leave fighting the criminals to us. Well, your job is to protect the matron and the elder kids. No one else can do that. You have to stay with them, encourage them, and support them. You're the only one that can do that, Clem. Only I can do it. Okay, I think I get what you're saying. You think you're up to it? You betcha, you can count on me. Thank you, yet again. Take care, everybody, if you're part of us. Oh, Miss Chloe. I can't wait to see you play. Great, I've been working so hard, and I hope everyone will be there. You can count on it. See you later. This episode will go on for ages. Glad to see he's feeling better. Sometimes you know just what to say, don't you, Joshua? I couldn't believe my eyes seeing how quickly Clem cheered up. Thank you, Joshua, so much. No, I didn't do anything special. You gotta protect what's important to you, that's all. Think from experience? No, I'm glad that he's okay. Thanks for your help, Cole. I should be thanking you. Oh, by the way, what came up for investigation? Well, the red-headed dude butted his spiky head in now, so I wonder if he's done yet. For now, let's go back to the guild. Are you coming with us, Cole? I just think I have to find out what's really going on. Not to mention the identity of the arsonist. Well, then let's go. You picked you a fight, why did you do it earlier? But you check out what you have on you. Water 2, HP 2, a heal, EP, mind cut. Why do you have so many water spells? How do you have time spells? A lot of time only. Maybe you can have defense too. There's an EP cut. And I gave you freaking Hellgate? Because I want Hellgate on somebody. Hellgate is awesome. Welcome back, and good work. I'm told you were able to save the young boy. Yeah, somehow or another, I'm still kind of in shock from when the redhead showed up. You must mean Agate. He's working on a case in ruin. He used to be a leader of the Ravens, if you can believe it. I suspected as much. Guess that explains his terrible disposition. Well, that was a long time ago. He drifted into town right around when he was your age, hung out with a rough crowd, and got into some serious trouble. Compared to back then, though, the tough types nowadays are puppy dogs. A guy like that was allowed to become a bracer? Well, I got to know him a little bit, and it turns out he wanted to become a bracer since he was little. Sometimes people just change. I think that's probably enough of the idle chatter. You're back! Don't ditch your mama tell you it ain't nice to talk about someone behind his back. Anyways, I always like gossip. But is it really gossip if it's positive? Anyway, are you done with the bigger investigation? Yep, overdone with it. I can't say for sure, but I think they're clean. Really? You're not just going to protect your old buddies. You want to watch that mouth of yours. From what I saw last night at the Sailor's Tavern, they could have been arsonists. Hell, I doubt they could even walk a straight line if they even wanted to. This is true. We can hold off on them for now. They do strike me as the types that get tend to guess that I have arson anyway. I guess just full of themselves, mostly. All you need to give them is a nasty look, and believe me, they'll cave in like dogs. Anyway, I'll see if I can find an arsonist and I'll let him out in the field. Huh? We'll take it over the case, and you're off it. Say what? You gotta be kidding me. Can you at least give us an explanation? I don't want your... Don't be a pain to the mod. You two were too close to this case, and you know it. And if you let your feelings run away with you, it screws with your judgment. Plus, you let a civvy get involved. Oh, pardon me, but you ain't gotta apologize. It's these two I'm worried about. The point is, you gotta be professional about it, and you two ain't. It's where do you get off calling us unprofessional? And no matter what you do, we made a promise to the mayor. Hey, Gene? What do we'll say about Junior seeing Bridges in the same case? Come on, you know as well as I do. Of course, it was a favor of the senior bracer. We're not bad in a fight. Perhaps we could provide backup? It's just an investigation. I don't need more people. I think we're done here. Try not to hold up. Time to hold this against me. What? Alright! Just who the hell does he think he is? It's frustrating, sure, but he has a point. It just irritates me that we really don't have a counter argument. I'm sorry, if I had drawn my sword. That's what was bothering me. He doesn't have to just blow us off like that. Please, he means no harm, don't be upset. Pact is not a strong suit, he just doesn't know how any other way to communicate. Particularly like the current situation. I think it may have been had something to do with an earlier case of his. He was pursuing something and well. Pursuing someone like a criminal? Never mind about that. I can't really go into details. Just let him handle these criminals. It's sort of a personal favor for me. I guess he has no choice. I see. Now we'll hand over our report for my investigation then. Just go ahead. You got some payment for it. It seems you were quite thorough. But as I mentioned, the circumstances in this case were special. I'm terribly sorry that you'll have to end your investigation here. But we just want to do something for the matron and the kids. Is this that right? Now, Mr. Jane, is it possible to enlist to help the Bridge Guild for civilian events, isn't it? Yes, though it would depend on what kind of event you're talking about, because the number of people who attend will be handling security for the Well Academy Festival, for example. Well, then, still, Joshua, would you mind helping out with our play in the meantime? Huh? What do you mean? Every year when the festival ends, there's a play held in the auditorium. I know the children always look forward to it, but there's still two major roles that haven't been filled. You don't mean who wants to take the parts. Yes, otherwise we may have to cancel the play entirely. I can't bear thinking about how disappointed the children would be. So I mentioned you two on the student council last night, and they seem quite eager to have you. Yeah, wouldn't be much, but you'd be reimbursed with the admin budget. Why do you want us? I don't think we'd be any good, and isn't the play a really big deal? Well, as for the girl part, we need someone who's been trained for combat. I think you fit the role perfectly. I see. I guess I can eventually do combat stuff. Because I get it work. What about the other part? Oh, well, talking about that is kind of embarrassing? What exactly kind of play is this? Oh, come on, Joshua, you're not going to make her say it, are you? If we can do something for the kids, what's the harm? Plus, if we do some work, they'll probably let us have some awesome festival food. We can't let an opportunity like this slip by. Hold on for a second. Jesus, really a legit bracer mission? Certainly is. Citizen outreach and regional services comprise plenty of general work that bracers do. That's just Agisha, if you don't have extra time, I certainly have no problem with it. Alright. I have a bad feeling about this. But if it's for the kids, what choice do I have? Still, if we have something else to do, we should take care of it beforehand. I doubt working on this play will leave us free time for anything else. Yeah, you're probably right. Okay, Cole. Would it be okay with you if we looked around for some more? Sure, I don't mind. Don't worry about me. You get to Royal Academy. You leave by the Gold Seaway. Seaside Way. Go east. Go east at the first fork and then follow the woodland path. Okay, got it. Well, then let's go. Got some new missions here. But we'll worry about all that stuff later. Right now, we've got to go put on a play. And see you all next time.